Mass is offered for the good health of the sick and old in our parish, for the soul of Rosie Dilemma by family, thanksgiving to Mother Mary by Smita Fernandez, thanksgiving to Infant Jesus by Alan Fernandez, soul of Rosie Dilemma by Georgina Lewis and family, for the soul of Melville Lewin by the loved ones, for the soul of Joe Manuel Vaz by Hedwig Vaz and family, for the soul of Joe Manuel Vaz by the family, thanksgiving for the gift of Arini by Amisha, Varun and family, for the good health of Mother by Alex Joseph and family, for the soul of Mr. and Mrs. Lobo by Rita Sundaram, for the soul of Henry Lobo by Roshni. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who by the abundance of your grace give increase to the people who believe in you, look with favor on those you have chosen and clothed with blessed immortality, those reborn through the sacrament of baptism. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
The first reading of the day is taken from the Acts of the Apostles. The rulers, elders, and scribes were astonished at the assurance shown by Peter and John. considering they were uneducated laymen, and they recognized them as associates of Jesus. But when they saw the man who had been healed standing by their side, they could find no answer. So they ordered them to stand outside while the Sanhedrin had a private discussion. What are we going to do with these men? They asked. It is obvious to everybody in Jerusalem that a miracle has been worked through them in public, and we cannot deny it. But to stop the whole thing spreading any further among the people, let us caution them never to speak to anyone in this name again. So they called them and gave them a warning on no account to make statements or to teach in the name of Jesus. But Peter and John retorted, "You must judge whether in God's eyes it is right to listen to you and not to God. We cannot promise to stop proclaiming what we have seen and heard." The court repeated the warnings and then released them. They could not think of any way to punish them, since all the people were giving glory to God for what had happened. This is the word of the Lord. For the responsorial psalm, let our response be, "I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer. I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer." Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love has no end. The Lord is my strength and my song. He was my savior. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just. Your response: "I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer." The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand raised me up. I shall not die. I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die. Your response: "I will give you, thank you, Lord, for you have given answer." Open to me the gates of holiness. I will enter and give thanks. This is the Lord's own gate where just may enter. I will thank you, for you have given answer, and you are my savior. Your response: "I will thank you, Lord, for you have given answer." Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, alleluia. The day was made by the Lord. We rejoice and be glad. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Having risen in the morning on the first day of the week, Jesus appeared first to Mary of Magdala, from whom he had cast out seven devils. She then went to those who had been his companions and who were mourning and in tears, and told them. But they did not believe her when they heard her say that he was alive and that she had seen him. After this, he showed himself under another form to two of them as they were on their way into the country. They went back and told the others, who did not believe them either. Lastly, he showed himself to the 11 themselves while they were at table. He reproached them for their incredulity and obstinacy because they had refused to believe those who had seen him after he had risen. And he said to them, "Go out to the whole world. Proclaim the good news to all creation." This is the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters, in today's gospel, we notice the apostles operating out of fear and disbelief. For example, Jesus appeared to Mary of Magdala. She went to the companions of Jesus and told them that he was alive, but they refused to believe her. After this, Jesus showed himself to the two of them on their way to Emmaus. These two went back and told the rest of them, but they did not believe them either. Lastly, my dear brothers and sisters, today we hear that Jesus showed himself to the 11 when they were on the table. And he reproached them because they had refused to believe that he was risen. And now, as they themselves saw Jesus alive in front of them, they believed in him. And then Jesus ordered them to go out to the whole world and proclaim the good news that he is alive. Now, commanded by Jesus himself, the apostles went out. And what we hear in the first reading is an account of their new life in Christ. They were out in public, preaching and healing. They were filled with the Holy Spirit. And now, as the scripture says, same Peter and John, who were afraid, scared, were now fearless. For example, they had just healed a crippled man, and the rulers, elders, and scribes wanted them to be punished. And they wanted them to stop preaching in the name of Jesus. So they threatened them. But Peter and John retorted, saying, whom shall we listen to, you or God? And without punishing the apostles, they left them to go. My dear brothers and sisters, let us believe that Jesus is risen. He is among us. He is opening our eyes. He is opening our hearts. Especially in this time of trials, when we too are scared, let us ask the gift of the Holy Spirit and be filled with the spirit of fearlessness. May the living God bless us all and fill us with his joy, love, and peace.
Thank you.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for the good of the good of the Holy Church.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to laud you, yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful, for his death is our ransom for death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Ratnaswami, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Rosie Dilema, Melville Lewin, Joe Manuel, Mr. and Mrs. Lobo, and Henry Lobo. Welcome them into the light of your face, O Lord. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Jesus taught us to call God our Father, and so we have the faith to say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to enter under my roof,
but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us everlasting life.
Isu pase saho avo thasho gunvan.
Isu pase saho avo thasho gunvan.
Isu pase paam shoi prakash no pran.
Isu pase paam shoi prakash no pran.
Divine Mercy Novena, 9th day. Today bring to me souls who have become lukewarm and immerse them in the abyss of my mercy. These souls wound my heart most painfully. My soul suffered the most dreadful loathing in the Garden of Olives because of the lukewarm souls. They were the reason I cried out, Father, take this cup away from me, if it be your will. For them, the last hope of salvation is to flee to my mercy. Let us pray for the lukewarm souls who caused our Savior such great suffering in Gethsemane. Most compassionate Jesus, you are the compassion itself. I bring lukewarm souls into the abode of your most compassionate heart. In this fire of your pure love, let these tepid souls, who like corpse, fill you with such deep loathing, be once again set aflame. O most compassionate Jesus, exercise the omnipotence of your mercy and draw them into the very ardor of your love and bestow upon them the gift of holy love, for nothing is beyond your power. Fire and ice cannot be joined. Either the fire dies or the ice melts. But by your mercy, O God, you can make up for all that is lacking. Eternal Father, turn your merciful gaze upon lukewarm souls who are nonetheless enfolded in most compassionate heart of Jesus. Father of mercy, I beg you, by the bitter passion of your Son and by his 3-hour agony on the cross, let them too glorify the abyss of your mercy. O day of eternity, O day so long desired, with thirst and longing my eyes search you out. Soon love will tear the veil asunder, and you will be my salvation. Prayer for healing. Jesus, divine mercy, compassionate Lord and greatest physician, you are intimately aware of the struggle we are experiencing today and these days, the bodily pain and the mental stress. Whenever the sick person approached you, pleading you for healing, you were moved with compassion and healed instantly. And at times, even your energy flowed to the patient from your body. We come with true faith in you and ardent desire to be healed of this illness. Silently pour out before the Lord your illnesses. We know you who came to the world to give life, life in abundance. We desire that you heal us too. You are our comfort and strength. Lord, may our pain and suffering bring us close to you. You who are the wounded healer, may we experience a total healing from this sickness, especially this COVID-19, and despair. Jesus, divine mercy, we trust in you. Jesus, divine mercy, may your pure and healthy blood circulate in our painful and ailing organism, and may your pure and healthy body transform our weak and healthy body, and may a healthy and vigorous life of yours flow once again within us and heal us totally, if it is truly your holy will. O blood and water which gushed forth from the heart of Jesus as fount of mercy for us, we trust in you. Let us pray. Look with the kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you were pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve one another.
We must return to the city to tell the others. Come with us. Woman, why weepest thou? Whom seekest thou?
Sir, if thou have borne him hence, tell me where thou hast laid him, and I will take him away.
Mary.
Rabboni.
Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father. But go to my brethren, and say unto them, I ascend unto my Father, and your Father, and to my God, and your God.